live in a place called Cancer Alley, and for those who aren't familiar, it's this roughly 70 to 80 mile stretch of towns from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, down to New Orleans, Louisiana. And they have an incredibly high concentration of chemical plants, oil refineries, and these companies are responsible for dumping tons of pollution and chemicals into the community, draining our reservoirs of drinking water, and causing lots of illness and disease. One of the reasons that fossil fuel companies still thrive in these areas are because people trust them. You know, BP, Exxon, Dow will provide for us that they built these towns, that they're going to stick around and take care of these towns. They're going to be part of the solution. But it's clear as time goes by that these fossil fuel companies can't be part of the solution because they created many of the problems we're facing now.
The fossil fuel industry has been stepping out of line for decades. It has been continually destroying the planet, and it does not seem to be on any kind of track to stop doing so. So at some point, we have to say, this is it. This is, like, enough is enough. This is where we draw the line. We are going to divest from you. The fossil fuel industry obviously could not survive without financial investments from major powerful institutions.
And divestment is one of the things that every institution can do right now to really show that they understand how important the issue is. And so it also takes away a lot of the social license that these fossil fuel companies have to operate, and shows them that if they're not getting to a point where they can become green energy companies, then they don't have a viable path forward.
That was Harvard, the richest educational institution in the world, saying, we don't think it's wise or responsible to invest in this industry anymore because of the harm they do and because it's just not a good investment anymore. Fossil fuels are a thing of the past.
So by showing that it can divest and it's going to do even better without the fossil fuel investments, then that it tees up a lot of other institutions to do the same and to know that they're doing so kind of in a protected way. Like this has the Harvard seal of approval.
We are wanting to take this historic win and grow it into a larger movement towards endowment transparency and endowment justice, and transparency and justice across Harvard University on a much broader scale.
I think that going forward, Harvard should keep doing what it does best, which is researching the technologies and all of the different things that are going to help us beat the climate crisis.
I think now, instead of fighting against something, it's time for us to start fighting for something. How can we leverage our position at Harvard, or how can we mobilize this wealth that's been so illegitimately accrued over hundreds of years to be part of a solution instead of part of a problem? How can we be creating goodness? How can we be generating a sustainable world?